We can do all kinds of good things, and we need to, and we're kind of starting to, but we've got to stop doing stupid things, or else we'll never catch up. We're already past where we should be, and we better take it awfully seriously.
Thank you.
Hey, Bill, thank you so much for being here and all the work that you've been doing.
Ben, thank you.
My name is Ben West. I'm a campaigner for the Wilderness Committee, and I'm so thrilled to hear you talking about how important the tankers in the Burrard Inlet are and the Enbridge pipeline, because it's basically my full-time job to work on that. And also specifically for bringing up the important role of First Nations here, because as everybody knows, you know, most of BC's unceded land. I also wanted to add a special thank you to the Coast Salish people, as was mentioned before, for hosting us here, the Musqueam, the Squamish, the Tsleil-Waututh. And in particular, I want to recognize the Sundance chief of the Tsleil-Waututh, Reuben George, who's here with us today, who's been playing a really critical role in helping to fight the oil tanker increase in the Burrard Inlet. And like a good environmental campaigner, I can't help but use the microphone for a shameless promotion. We actually just launched a service to track the oil tankers in the inlet, because all these increases have been happening without anybody knowing about it. There's actually been big increases since Kinder Morgan bought the pipeline already that nobody ever gave permission for. And so to sort of shine a light on it, we've actually created a service now where if you text the word oil on your cell phone, so anybody who's got a cell phone wants to do it right now, it's just the word oil to the phone number is 604-800-9180, 604-800-9180, and you'll get a text message every time an oil tanker enters the Burrard Inlet, and it'll tell you how you can get involved in the campaign, how you can take action. If you're like me, you could also just go to Twitter, and we've got a Twitter account that gives you even more information, which is Burrard Inlet Oil on Twitter. So I guess I really didn't have a question
That's better than a question. It also makes clear one of the things, when we get all depressed about how the oil companies have all the money and things, it's true. But there are some things working in our advantage, and one of them is these sort of new and interesting set of communications technologies. So, for instance, when we started 350.org, we took every penny we could raise, which was about $40,000, and used it to build a website. And it was really good, it was and is a really good website. It works at certain moments anyway in 11 or 12 languages. And it's, great and interesting and filled with beautiful pictures and stuff. Now, I have no doubt that Exxon spent, $40 million building its website. But in fact, it's no better. It's not anywhere near as good, It's just like a bunch of pictures of, penguins and all the other things that they're killing, So we have some possibilities here. I mean, we were able to knit together this 350 thing out of, spit and shoestring and Twitter and Flickr and Skype, And it's possible, in certain ways. And we'll see. We'll see. That's a really beautiful, that's a great idea. I like that.
Cool. Thank you.